Alright, hello everybody. I think I'm live. My name is Dora. I'm the organizer of this group. And for those of you who are new to this group, I come on here live every Tuesday at 9 a.m. Pacific time to connect with you all and to answer any questions that might have come up during the week. And also to, you know, use this opportunity as a mini training, if you like, on the different topics that I'm passionate about, which is really, if you're in this group, you'll understand that I focus on stress and how we can use holistic practices and tools and modalities that could help us to restore our health. But health, I guess, you know, is a really broad term, because if you know me, if you've worked with me, you'll know that I view health in a holistic sense. And it's really about connecting all aspects of your health. So which is your mind, your body, your soul or spirit. But, you know, we're all connected, right? So we want to also take into account, you know, everything else that may be causing you stress or that you perceive to be stresses in your life, no matter what they are, it's going to impact on all the other aspects of health. And so each week I bring to you a particular topic that we talk a little bit about. And today or this week we're talking about sleep. And I think that, you know, sleep, more and more I'm finding that it's not something that comes easily for many people. I myself am blessed with sort of easy sleep and restful sleep, and but certainly when I had my boys, you know, I was sleep deprived for, you know, the first 13 months of each of their lives. They were waking up every 2 hours to feed. And so I experienced what it was like to have sleep deprivation. And of course, during my university days, I also didn't get much sleep then. And so I certainly could or have had the experience of not getting enough sleep versus when I have enough sleep, and I can definitely feel a huge difference mentally, emotionally, and physically between the two states. And so what's surprising to me was when I start to work with my clients and even to talk to family members and friends, I realize that sleep is not something that just comes easily or naturally to many people. But having said so, it's really also very surprising to see that even though this is the case, even though many people are not getting restful sleep or they're not getting enough sleep, it's not something that tends to be prioritized. We often feel like it's okay not to have enough sleep. We may put other things, you know, ahead of ourselves. For instance, maybe we prioritize exercise or our diet or something else. But sleep, at least with my experience and the people I've talked to, I'm not generally prioritized as the number one thing that they want to improve on in helping them to improve their health. And I think this might be because we are now in, you know, in the society that wants, or that's quite demanding, right? So we have so much that we want to do in a day. And we want to make sort of more time for ourselves. And in doing so, we have to sacrifice something because we only have 24 hours in a day. And so if we wanted to make more time for ourselves, then we will have to, you know, obviously take up less time in something else. And unfortunately, more often than not, we end up sacrificing our sleep. Because now we perceive that we are making more time for ourselves, we're creating more hours in the days by sleeping less. Unfortunately, this is, I feel anyway, this is going about it the wrong way. Okay, there's, I mean, sure, you might get that extra couple of hours by not going to bed, but the impact on your health by not sleeping, so consistently not getting enough sleep, and even by a couple of hours can be quite significant for your body. So sleep is so, you know, it's an understatement to say that sleep is important. And I think Matthew Walker, who's a sleep researcher, actually argue that sleep is sort of the okay, I don't want to say it incorrectly, but just sort of the essence of what he was saying is that perhaps sleep is the main essence of our being, and that our awakened state is not so much, we're not sleeping so that we can be awake and function. It might be the other way around. It's maybe that the core of our being is actually it's happening in our sleep, because there's so much that goes on when we're sleeping. And maybe perhaps you don't realize that you know, our bodies and our minds can be just as active and just doing processes or jobs that are actually as important as when we are awake. And so when we start to take away time from our sleep, a lot of research is coming out, sleep research is coming out to show that, you know, a lot of the chronic diseases are linked to having insufficient sleep, or having insufficient quantity or quality of sleep. And so when we're asleep, we're not conscious of what's going on. Maybe we dream sometimes, and we might even be conscious of our dreams from time to time. But there's so much more that's happening when we're asleep. And if you're interested in learning about more, I highly recommend you read Matthew Walker's book called Why We Sleep. And I'll put a link to that book in the comments below if you're interested. But it goes in depth as to why sleep is not just, you know, important, it's essential for health. And in fact, when we're not getting enough sleep, you know, you can't, you won't get the full benefits of exercising. You won't get the full benefits of eating a good diet. Like, so things that we kind of think of as important for health, which they are, sleep and exercise and nutrition are definitely key to a healthier body. But in the book, he'll explain what you'll find is that he's saying that actually sleep is going to be even more important than those two, because when you're not getting enough sleep, those kinds of processes are also going to be affected. And so sleep is hugely important, but it's not something that I feel we're taking it seriously. And I think that sometimes people feel like, well, I only need a few hours of sleep and I feel fine. Well, the thing is, and I think we've talked about this in the body, in previous topics, is that the body is really adaptable and resourceful and resilient to a point, right? And so you may not see the effects of you not sleeping right away, or maybe the symptoms or yeah, the symptoms that you experience may not be so drastic that you feel like, oh, this is a problem, or you might feel like, oh, I can handle it. But when we continue with behaviors that are unnatural to our bodies, unhealthful to our bodies, there will come a time where it'll catch up to us, and that's when we're gonna be like, oh, you know, bummer, you know, now I have to deal with this maybe much bigger symptom or ailment or illness, you know, that may have the root cause in not sleeping consistently over a long period of time. And so I just went off track there, so let me bring it back. So when we deprive ourselves of sleep, and I say that we deprive ourselves of sleep, this is because another really interesting point that Matthew Walker brought up was that we're the only species on this planet that would, deliberately deprive ourselves of sleep. No other animals do this. When they're tired, they go to sleep. They don't force themselves to stay awake when their body and everything about them is telling them that they are tired and they should be sleeping. And why do we do this? Well, like I mentioned before, it's a lot stems from the belief that we don't have enough time in a day to do everything that we want to do. But one thing is, that I'd love for you to challenge yourself with this is this really the case? Is it really the case that I don't have enough time? Or is it the case of not having enough energy to do what you want in a day? Because oftentimes, it's not that we don't have enough time, we don't feel productive to or we tend to procrastinate, or we don't feel motivated or energetic to finish a task within a certain set time or a certain period of time, and we might end up dragging things out for much longer than they need to, right? And how often do you catch yourself being unproductive? When you're just scrolling through social media, watching, funny videos online or whatnot, if we add those kind of minutes throughout the day, you'd be surprised how much time that we actually spend procrastinating because we don't feel motivated to actually do the work that we set for ourselves. And so, why do we have a tendency for that? And there are many reasons why. But one reason could be that because we are not getting enough sleep. So, like I said, sleep impacts us in so many ways. And, when we're not sleeping enough mentally, we're not, when, we are going to be affected mentally, in that we're not going to be able to function as well as if we did have enough sleep. And so that in itself is going to decrease productivity. You're going to find it much harder to stay focused, to concentrate, and to stay on task. You're going to get distracted easily. And when you get distracted, especially in this day and age where distraction is, there's an abundance of distractions, and you get into a video and you get kind of, sucked into that for a little while, and then, you feel like, oh my gosh, where did the time go? And trying to get back on task. And that's not helpful, right? Emotionally, we get affected by not getting enough sleep. So our emotions are also going to affect the thoughts that we have, and the way that we behave and the way that we react and interact with other people. And physically, obviously, there are going to be physical consequences as well when we're not getting enough sleep. And so all of these things together, and also our creativity is drastically hindered when we're not sleeping. And so creativity is also very important for us being productive in many different areas of life, right? And so this is where we get stuck sometimes when we feel stuck, when we're trying to do something, or when we're trying to be innovative or problem solve, all of these things we need to have. It's always going to work best when we're feeling our best, when our minds are working well, when we're creative, when we feel, in a state of some sort of relaxation, or, because when you're always on high alert, it's going to be really difficult also because you're under stress, right? And insufficient sleep is a source of stress on the body. And so all of these things are actually working against you, and it's making you less productive during the day. And so, what if we got enough sleep for ourselves? so that we can start to, if you like, rebalance all of these other areas in our lives. We may start to feel that, we're able to stay focused, we're able to work much more productively, we're more creative, we feel happier, we feel like we achieve something, we feel there's a whole different shift in energy to it once you're in the flow and producing and working in a way that feels productive to you, right? So that's one thing. And the other thing is sometimes we often overplan as well. We have unrealistic expectations as to how much work that we should get done in a day. And there's this sort of urgency and impatience about, getting things done. And I'm not saying that we don't have a lot to do, but sometimes some of these tasks are not time sensitive and that they can be done on another day or maybe spread out through the week. And so instead of accumulating all of these jobs and seeing this huge long list of things that we have to do, you might start to really go through the list and be honest with yourself as to, am I really going to get all of these things done today? Because when we plan too much and set unrealistic expectations for ourselves, most of the time we will feel quite stressed out trying to complete everything. There'll be times, and maybe it might be also quite often, that we don't complete everything on the list. And so now we're feeling tired, we're feeling exhausted, and even though we've achieved, quite a number of things that day, we still feel like we failed somehow, that we, that we weren't productive enough, and then we feel guilty about it. And so all of these things make us feel worse about ourselves, not better, right? And then when we're feeling like that, we may also fall into other sort of habits that are not so healthful either. And another thing is really getting intentional about what it is you want to do that day and why it is important for you to get those things done. Are you doing those things because you think that those are things that are expected of you? Excuse me. Are those expectations placed on by other people, by yourself? Are you doing them to people please? Or are you doing them because they're important to you? Or are you doing these things or rushing through life because you feel like, well, I cannot relax and enjoy myself until I've gotten these things done? And the chances are, every day you're going to have a bulk of tasks and activities that you have to get through before you're allowed to enjoy yourself, or do something that you love. And I find that this is really tricky because we tend to then rush through life, focus on all of these tasks that we are not enjoying, and then at the end of the day, we actually didn't make time for ourselves to do the things that are meaningful and important to us. And so when we are planning our day or our lives, maybe taking time to think about what is important to me and how can I make sure that I make time for what's really important to me, and everything else that has to be done are going to work around what's important. And if they're going to help add value to your life, yes, do those tasks. But, being really aware of why you're doing these things, why are these things on your list, and really learning to perhaps let go a little bit of some of these things that you think you need to do, but perhaps maybe you really don't. And so, yeah, so sometimes maybe it's not about trying to make more time in the day, but it's maybe thinking about how can we be more productive in a day, and how can we, start to just be more intentional with the things that we want to do in a day so that we can enjoy life as we're living through it instead of trying to give ourselves that as a reward for rushing through a list of things that we, perhaps aren't important to us, that we don't enjoy, and it's really taking, taking life out of us. So then, in changing a little bit our perspective about how we live, and prioritizing the different things in our lives, I would also suggest that we start to prioritize sleep more and more. And I know at the beginning, it might be a little bit difficult because it does really feel like, I finally I have an hour to myself. The kids are in bed. I finish, everything I needed to do that day. But I would just encourage you to just try it, for a few weeks, just to try to prioritize your sleep. Notice how you feel, right, when you're getting more quantity and quality or better quality of sleep. Notice how you feel when you are getting enough, restful sleep. And you will be maybe pleasantly surprised to find that even though you're sleeping more, you're going to have more time for yourself and you're going to feel more energetic and you're going to have a better quality of life. Now, of course, there are many reasons why some people are not getting enough sleep or not getting enough good quality sleep. And sleep is a, really big topic. And like I said, it's not the only thing that happens to us. And just as sleep can impact on many areas of our lives, many areas, I mean, it's vice versa, right? Many areas of our lives can also impact the way that we sleep. And so, definitely, I'd be happy to talk to you more about this if you're interested. But for now, I think I'll just end. I like to end with just leaving you a few tips as to how we can start to cultivate cultivate a practice that could help us to prepare our body a little bit better for sleep. And I think, because of my interest, right, on stress, one of the biggest or most yeah the biggest impact I think on sleep is stress. And so if we can start to decrease stress in your life, whatever, however your stress might show up to you, we start to take away some of that burden. That in itself could already drastically improve the quantity and quality of sleep that you are getting. By decreasing stress, we can start to downregulate your nervous system. And I think this is one of the big issue with people who have trouble falling asleep or staying asleep or getting good quality sleep, is that they're in this fight or flight mode all the time. And it makes it really hard for you to turn in at night. Now, so the five tips that I want to cover. Tip number one, try to be consistent with your bedtime and wake time. Okay, so there may be a time that you're sleeping right now. If you're going to bed at, I don't know, say 11, 11:30, whatever time you go to bed, and you wake up the next morning and you need an alarm to wake you up, and then you hit the snooze button a few times and you wake up feeling unrefreshed, that's a good sign that you're not getting enough sleep, or you're not getting enough good quality sleep, and perhaps you're sleeping too late, right? So what is a time that you need to go to bed so that you can begin to wake up, naturally on the next day at the time that you want? And at the beginning, it's going to be much harder for you to say shift to, oh, now going from 11:30, I'm going to start to sleep at, 9:30 or something like that, right? So it's about maybe making little shifts. So can you shift your bedtime by 15 minutes, and you do that throughout a couple of weeks and slowly shift to a time that that's going to work for you. And I understand that, you have your social, maybe social life, family life, or whatever, that you also want to be a little bit flexible about. So just testing it out and finding a time that's going to work for you, but that's going to be closer to what your body wants in terms of sleep. So be consistent. Once you have a bedtime that you know works for you, be consistent with that time. Go to bed the same time every night, including weekends if you can. So I know sometimes we want to relax, and or there may be other things that go on the weekend that shifts our bedtime, but you don't want it to be so drastically shifted. So you don't want to suddenly shift by a few hours and then you sleep in by a few hours over the weekend, because in a way that you're creating basically mini jet lag symptoms every single week for yourself, right? So try to be consistent, try to stay within, the 45 minutes or to an hour if you do make those little shifts from night to night or day to day, but try to make it as consistent as possible. Tip number two is get out, if the weather permits, get outside every day. And if you can, get it as close to sort of the first thing in the morning as you can for yourself. So when you wake up, get some sunlight, and it doesn't have to be a long, long time being outside, even just a few minutes. Just go outside, reset your master clock, because the sunlight is very powerful. We get signals that the light that comes through our eyes starts to signal to our master body clock to, as to what time it is, because we do run on a circadian rhythm, and our sleep cycle, and many biological cycles function, alongside that. Number three, exercise, okay, or movement, if you like. Moving your body often is going to be very helpful for sleep. And in fact, as you exercise, and of course, exercise, within what is going to be beneficial to you. Over-exercising is not going to be beneficial. So regular exercises is going to help you to get more of that deep restorative sleep at night. And the deep restorative sleep is, when we're in, as you can understand, it's very restorative for the body. That's when we do our maintenance and repair and healing. All of that happens in our deep sleep. Reducing blue light exposure at night, with all our devices and whatnot, it can disrupt our sleep cycle as well. It kind of tricks the body in thinking that it's still daytime, and so then of course we're not tired when we should be tired. And so reducing blue light exposure, putting on whatever filters that I think a lot of the phones and laptops and devices that we have automatically has a night mode or night switch function where they change the display on the screen such that there's much less blue light that's being emitted. There are also blue light blocking glasses that you can wear, or amber tinted glasses that you can wear at night that can help further reduce those blue light. And then another thing is just, maybe set a habit of not looking at devices a couple of hours before bedtime, or even reducing the time you spend on these devices, in the evenings. And then number five, lastly, avoid eating a big meal before bedtime. So we're not really digesting our foods in a big way when we're sleeping. And so we want to make sure that we eat, and I would wait at least 2 or 3 hours after your last meal before going to bed, and maybe making dinner one of the lighter meals of the day. And of course, this is just a general guideline. I know there are some people with hypoglycemia that may need to actually snack before going to bed. But again, we're not thinking of like a huge, buffet meal before you go to bed. That's not going to be helpful, and it could help you, sorry, it might actually cause you to wake up more frequently during the night. So, of course, like I mentioned, sleep is a hugely important aspect of health, plays a huge role in the stress that we feel from day to day. But again, this is one piece of the puzzle when it comes to true health. So we must think of our bodies in a holistic way because everything is connected. And even though it may be easy to identify that, you have, oh, I have problems with sleeping and I'll just go fix that. The root cause of why you are not sleeping sometimes is not so obvious. And I think that in the end, it's really, whatever you think the problem is, there's a deeper layer to that. And so we need to really be addressing the whole person, whole body, the whole mind, body, and soul. And in doing so, then you will find true healing, health, and happiness. So if you have any questions, or if you want to find out more about how you can get more restful sleep, definitely comment below or reach out to me directly. I'd be happy to connect you and help you on your way. So I will end it here. Gosh, my trainings are getting longer and longer, and I'm gonna try to reverse that so that I'm not taking so much time each session. But anyway, I will connect with you again next week, Tuesday at 9 a.m. Pacific time. Have a wonderful week, guys.